All right, here we go. Good evening, everyone. My name is Justin Pugh, your child's music teacher. Give it up for our instrumental music teacher, Mr. Messinger, and his band and orchestra. I know. I know they have been working hard for tonight, as the rest of the fifth grade has, for our performance in chorus tonight. Our theme for tonight's songs is hope, faith, and the power of positive thinking. In the world that we live in today, when some of us have bad days, bad weeks, and so on, it is important for us to remember there's always tomorrow. If we can get through today, hopefully tomorrow or the next day will be better. I've learned a lot about manifesting good things happening in the past year, and I have had some wonderful events in my life happened since a year ago. I'm wearing my red jacket for our first song since the main character from the musical famously wore a red dress. My red dress was in the dry cleaners, and so I wore this instead. But as I wore this today, students told me I looked like a waitress in a fancy restaurant. Yes, a waitress. I was told I looked like Willy Wonka, and I was told I looked like the president. I'm not sure if he said a president or the president, and I'm also not sure which out of those three is the most offensive. But join me at the beginning of this song will be Zara Wamate, and here to tell us more about our first song is Jasmine Kane.
It has been made into many productions in different countries and won 7 Tony Awards, including Best Musical. The musical song Tomorrow and It's a Hard Not Life are among its most popular musical numbers. It has been made into a movie 4 different times. Tonight we will be performing its most popular song, Tomorrow, where the lyrics encourage an optimistic point of view of life. We hope you enjoy our version, which was produced by Mr. Pugh, who performed and recorded the guitars, drums, and bass guitar.
There's a flower and the sorrow till there's none.
All right, so there are two things. There are two things I'll never forget about this next song, Rainbow Connection. The first time I heard it was when I first saw the Muppet movie, about 6 or 7 years old, watching Kermit the Frog play banjo in the swamp. I was convinced that Kermit was either absolutely real, or they had a really, really skinny guy in a Kermit costume, because instead of being behind a wall where the puppeteer hid, you could actually see Kermit's entire body moving his hands to play banjo, which I couldn't understand. The second time I remember specifically hearing this song was when I was riding the bus to school in eighth grade back in 1990, and they announced that Jim Henson had died. The morning DJ played the song, and there wasn't a dry eye on that bus as the man who gave us so many characters that we had grown up loving had died. Here is Kenzie Hess to tell us more.
Our next selection, Rainbow Connection, was written by Paul Williams for the movie The Muppet Movie. And it is another song about hope, optimism, and faith. The lyrics imply there's power in your thoughts. When puppeteer Jim Henson was brought into the music studio to sing and record his voice as Kermit the Frog, Paul Williams said that Jim Henson just couldn't get into the groove of the song. Paul suggested to Jim that he go and get the Kermit the Frog puppet and have Kermit sing the song. When Jim had Kermit on his hand doing the singing, the magic of the song came to life. The song has been covered over 35 times by major recording artists, including The Carpenters, Willie Nelson, Jason Mraz, Weezer, and Gwen Stefani.
And on the duet, we have Marta Kisleva and Leilani Martinez. And on the keyboard, we have Gabriela Santiago. Gabriela, you want to play a couple notes?
Yeah. guys.
So before we get to our last song, I want to thank all the fifth grade teachers, as well as the special area teachers for their assistance tonight. Thank you to Mr. Messinger for, once again, his help and guidance as a fellow music teacher. I'd like to thank Mrs. Lewis and Mrs. Markle, our wonderful administration. Give them a big hand, please. I'd like to give a special shout out, if she's around, to Mrs. Dornbush. Can you step in for a second, Mrs. Dornbush? For those of you who don't know, our fifth grade teacher had to go on leave, but Mrs. Dornbush stepped in and took a huge role of teaching these lovely fifth graders that I'll never forget. Thank you for all of you coming out to support your children. They will remember that you were here forever. And speaking of family coming out, I want to thank my family for being here tonight. My wife, my son, a man who has been my second father and employer, summer employer of 33 years in his family. By the way, please come out to Ultimate Water Sports for some paddleboarding and kayaking. Visit www.ultimatewatersports.com for more details. Yes, shameless plug. And most importantly, my mom, who has always come out to support me at all my performances on stage since the age of three, when my first performance was at a Muppet Show play. I sang a duet of Let Me Entertain You. And with me as always is my father in spirit. Hey, and one last thing. My mom has a birthday coming up in the beginning of June. It's an important one that ends in a zero. You would never believe her age by how beautiful and energetic she is. But let's just say that at her age, she can actually say that she's younger than the cover model of the Sports Illustrated swimsuit issue, Martha Stewart. So could you all please just real quick sing happy birthday to the original Mrs. Pugh? There are a few of them out there, but let's sing happy birthday to the original one, whom without her, I wouldn't be here. Ready? One, two, three.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Nana. Happy birthday to you.
Dressed up.
We've got lots of people playing instruments up here with us. And if you are ready to sing with us, that'd be great. We're going to have Jasmine come over and tell us a little bit more about our song.
Selection. question is based on a song by the rap band Green Day. Being one of Mr. Pugh's favorite bands, Mr. Pugh decided to change the lyrics of Green Day songs to lyrics that encourage students to read books and go to the library. He recorded them on 4 different CDs, and all proceeds went to the Pine Grove PTA. His CDs were sold all over the world and featured on various news and radio outlets, including being featured on the famous Howard Stern radio show. The song called I Wouldn't Go to the Library became a fan favorite at schools around Maryland, where Mr. Pugh would perform assemblies for free.
Filling in for William was Rue, but William came in just at the last second. Thanks. Thanks, Rue. Give it up for Rue, everybody. And on the harmonica we have Mr. Owen Fry. And on the drums we have Mr. Samuel Navarro. Happy spring, happy summer. See you all next time.